načalnog duha. Najljubljeniji, koliko se radujem i srce moje se raduje u meni što se evo opet nalazim ovde u ovoj vašoj divnoj i čestitoj sredini. Na ovaj današnji dan čuli smo jednu veoma neobičnu parabolu, priču Hristovu, koja je dosta teška shvatiti i razumeti. U stvari, počevši od pre tri nedelje, čitamo samo parabole i šta to znači za nas i radi našega spasenja. Ušli smo u jednom periodu kada Hristos više ne odgovara neposredno svojim apostolima i učenicima na njihovim pitanjima i nedoumicama, nego ispriča im priču i oni trebaju sami da iscrpe značenje od toga, da crpe značenje od toga kako bi oni došli do svog odgovora na njihova pitanja ili te neke nedoumice njihove. Čuli smo danas o jednome čoveku, caru, koji je pripremio svadbu, veliku gozbu za venčanje njegovog sina. Sveti vladika Nikolaj upozorava nas da bismo shvatili od samog početka ovu parabolu, jako je bitno znati koji je redosled reči. Beše čovek car. Zašto je bilo Hristu potrebno da naglasi da je on čovek, pa tek onda car? Odgovor nam dolazi od našeg velikoga savremenog svetitelja, patrijarha srpskoga Pavla, koji, kao što svi znamo, i sva dečica po beogradskim ulicama znaju da ponavljaju njegove reči: budimo ljudi, budimo ljudi. Jer ako čovek zna šta znači biti čovek, tek onda znače šta znači biti car, biti sluga, biti sveštenik, biti vernik, biti radnik, biti gazda. Čovek na prvom mestu mora biti čovek, upravo to. I tek onda onaj koji je car shvatit će da je on svima sluga i služitelj. Onaj koji je sluga ili služitelj, tek onda kao čovek će shvatiti da svi oni koji su na poslednjem mestu bit će pozvani da budu na prvom mestu. Međutim, ako čovek nije to otkrio u svom srcu, on nikako ne može shvatiti Hristove reči. I zato Gospod sve što je izustio, izustio je u vidu parabole ili priče, jer želi da nam otvori srca, i ne samo da nam otvori srca, da nam otvori razum, svest o sebi, ko smo mi, šta smo mi, zašto nas je Bog stvorio. Onaj koji je čovek je Hristova i slika i prilika u ovom svetu. I svaki čovek beše pozvan jednako kao što je car pozvao zvanice na svadbi svoga sina. Svi smo mi pozvani na tu istu gozbu. A koja je ta gozba? Taj car u toj priči upravo jeste Bog Otac. Čije je venčanje? Venčanje njegovog sina Isusa Hrista. Međutim, svi mi znamo da se Hristos nije venčao. Koja je njegova nevesta? Crkva je njegova nevesta. I on nas poziva svake nedelje o svakom prazniku bez izuzetka da prisustvujemo, da učestvujemo upravo u svetoj liturgiji, jer se govori o ovoj gozbi, o svetoj liturgiji. Naradi se samo o jednom banketu. I kako mi, kao oni u toj paraboli, jako lako znamo da nađemo neki izgovor: previše sam umoran, suviše mi je toplo danas, neću danas, sutra ću, mogu da se pomolim jednako kod kuće kao i crkvi. I onda čovek treba da stekne svest o tome da kad je on sam, on je usamljen, on je jedinica, a kad pak dođe u hram, on postaje sastavni deo jedne zajednice i po učenju naše svete crkve spasenje bi u okviru zajednice. Međutim, nešto se veoma neobično desilo. One zvanice, svi su našli neki izgovor, reče car, Bog, idite po ulicama, pozovite svakoga prolaznika, neka uđe. I sveti vladika Nikolaj, 50. godina besedivši u Clevelandu, rekao je, kako ste vi Srbi u Americi podigli lepe, prelepe hramove o svakom koraku, ako ih vi ne ispunite, vi i deca vaša, oduzet će se svaka jedna crkva od vas i daće onim drugima koji će Gospod tražiti po ulicama. I zaista to je iskreno i ispravno upozorenje svima nama. Narod je došao, narod je napunio Gospu, napunio je hram, međutim, jedan uočio je car, veše bez svadbene ruke. Što to znači? Nije se dovoljno dobro obukao, naprotiv, ne znači to uopšte, nego znači da nije imao svoju belu haljinu koja se nosi na takvim, o takvim prilikama i na takvim gozbama. Zašto bela haljina? Zašto je to svadbena ruka? Jer upravo odgovor dolazi iz otkrovenje svetog Jovana na kraju svetoga pisma, kada je rekao, oni koji su spašeni, oni će biti odeveni u belim haljinama i pohranjeni ispod časne trpeze. Bela haljina je ona haljina koju smo svi mi, bez izuzetka, dobili o našem krštenju. I zato, upravo toga radi, svaki svešteno služitelj o svakoj liturgiji nosi prvo beli stihar koji predstavlja tu i takvu belu haljinu, svadbenu ruku predstavlja, a predstavlja ono lepo odelce, haljinicu koju smo mi dobili o našem krštenju, jer svaki sveštenik kada služi liturgiju predstavlja sve nas pred predstavom samoga Isusa Hrista. Beloved, on this day we have heard Jesus Christ talk about a wedding feast. And can you tell me, why would Jesus Christ, when somebody asks him a question, why would he say a story? Come here, girls, come here, we need you as well. Dođite, dođite. I need help. Deda Vladika needs you to help me with this sermon. Why do you think Jesus tells a story instead of giving an answer? What does he want us to do?
To find out what you should do yourself.
Absolutely. Look at how smart you are. To find out what you need to do yourself. So when we get a story, we either read it or what? Listen to the story. Very good. Now, in this story today, there was a man, a king, who wanted to give a big wedding feast for his son. But all of the people that he invited said, sorry, I have other things to do, and they didn't come. So the king, as we heard, did what? He invited everybody from the streets, come in. Come into the wedding of my son. And then what happened when he spotted one man? Do all of you have stihari on you? The girls have beautiful dresses on them today, but you have vestments on, yes? And he looked over and he saw one man. What did he say to him? Why didn't you come with what? Did you hear? Your wedding outfit. In other words, you weren't dressed properly. Does that mean that Jesus wants to make sure we all come dressed when we come to church? Because what is this story all about? Is it about just a wedding feast or something else? Why are we here today in church? What do we call this service? Can you say liturgy? liturgy, I didn't hear, I'm getting old. Liturgy, tako, mama, tata, deda, baka, we all have to hear you too. Liturgy, say it in Serbian, sveta liturgija.
Sveta liturgija.
Tako, tako. So when you go home, and if they didn't understand something, you can help them to understand today's gospel story. So when we come to church, are we supposed to come sloppily dressed or nicely dressed? Nicely dressed. And when you're baptized, can you tell me what color robe is everybody given? A white robe. Very good. Because it represents purity. And why a white robe? Where do you see, and if you understood Serbian, you already have the answer. Where do you see white robes on the priests? Which robe is it? Is it the first robe? Yes, it's called a stikad. Everybody say stikad.
Stikad.
Stikad. First robe. So the priest, when he wears a white robe underneath everything, represents all of us who were baptized. And so, in the end of all that has been written in the Holy Gospel, in everything else, the epistles, there's a book of Revelation which says, those who have a white robe will be placed safely under the holy altar table. So God will take care of everybody who belongs to Him. Now, there's a warning in all of this. When we come to liturgy, are we just supposed to come to liturgy to listen, to sit, to yawn, to stand? What is the real reason we come to liturgy? To do what? To receive? Molite I Holy Communion. Say Sveto Pričešće. Sveto Pričešće. So, you come, if somebody invites you to their house or to a wedding to be a guest and you say, no thank you, I've already eaten, are they going to be happy with you? You know, when mama is preparing for guests to come over to the house and somebody says, oh, I've already eaten, I don't need your food. Is that nice? No. Why does not? Oh, see, this is the best person here. What's the dad say? She's going, see, what color dress does she have on? White. She has a proper dress. What should she also do? Sedi tu, sedi. Opa, opa, opa. Ha, ha, ha. The smell of it. See, she heard the call of God and she came. So, we are invited every liturgy to take Holy Communion, to receive Jesus Christ's body and blood. That's why Jesus said, I'm the bread of life and I am the living waters. So if you eat from His bread, take His body, drink from His waters, receive His holy blood, will we ever be thirsty or hungry again? No, because it's a special food. Where does that food lead us? To heaven. Can McDonald's lead us to heaven? Not at all. So, Holy Communion leads us to heaven. God bless you. That's a, your answers are wonderful. You heard this morning we said special prayers for you, and we will say a special prayer at the end of service when we will bless you for the beginning of your new school year. So make sure you listen. I understand Father Peter is going to help teach you. So make sure you listen to everything, everything. And like I said, when you come home, mama, tata, do you know what we learned today? And so you can help them, even Deda and Baka, if they're around, you can tell them as well. And share with your brothers and sisters, because it's good to know as much as you can. Learn in school everything that your teachers teach you, and you will live a good and a happy life. Živi bili, Bog vas blagoslovio, srećan i blagosloven neka bude ovaj današnji dan i početak školske godine za ovu našu divnu i predivnu dečicu. Amin. Bože daj. Thank you.